our textbook, cyclic process is mentioned as a unique type of process, but in reality, cyclic process is a mathematical outcome of, or you can say, cyclic process is defined mathematically rather than, you know, physically what is going on. Okay. So basically in a cyclic process, please write down cyclic process. So in a cyclic process, state of the system repeats after every few intervals of time. Okay, so basically whatever was a state earlier, the same state is achieved again and again. Okay, so what happens is a cyclic process in PV diagram looks like a closed loop. Okay, so please write down cyclic process can be represented by a loop in a graph. Okay, so a loop can be like this. This is a loop. It goes like this, like that, and like this. Now, it doesn't happen only once. This thing keeps on happening again and again and again. Same thing repeats, all right? So if you have to study the cyclic process, you don't need to study all the cycles. It keeps on happening till infinity. So whatever happens to one cycle of repetition, same thing will happen for all the cycle of repetitions. Okay, so I just need to analyze what is happening in one of the cycles, and that is true for complete this thing. Okay, so basically machines follow cyclic processes. So cyclic process, please note down another point. Is nothing but is a collection of multiple processes to generate a closed loop. Okay, simple. Now, can you tell me in a cyclic process, if you start from here and end also there, what will be the change in internal energy for entire cyclic process?
Zero.
Because delta T is zero, you started from same temperature and ended at the same temperature. Delta U for entire cyclic process is zero. Getting it? Now I'm going to ask you a simple question. Tell me that first law of thermodynamics, which states delta Q is equal to delta U plus W, that first law of thermodynamics, is it valid for one type of process at a time? Or can I apply first law of thermodynamics for multiple processes together? Okay, what I mean to say is this. For example, this is the plot, let us say. This is P and V. And suppose the gas undergoes isochoric process and then isobaric process like this. Okay, so point one, then two, then three. Okay, now tell me the first law of thermodynamics, delta Q is equal to delta U plus W. By the way, first law of thermodynamics, you apply between the two points. Apply between the two points. Okay. Whereas PV is equal to NRT is applied at a single point. Single point, all the variables. Here you are applying between the two points. Delta Q is equal to delta U plus W. Now tell me, can I apply delta Q is equal to delta U plus W between 1 and 2 and then 2 and 3? Or can I apply for 1, 2, 3 directly? Just tell me, can I apply first law of thermodynamics between 1 and 3 directly or not?
Yes, and you can.
Just take the poll, don't say anything. Can I apply first law of thermodynamics between 1 and 3 directly? Between 1 and 3 directly, or do I need to break it like 1 to 2, then 2 to 3? You don't need to be careful in taking the vote. Whatever you may feel, take it. It is an anonymous poll. I'll not get to know who has answered what. Okay. So this is what you can see. Okay. The answer is that first law of thermodynamics is one of the fundamental theorem in the universe. Okay, so it does not matter between which two point you are applying. It is independent of that. So when we have studied the first law of thermodynamics, I never told you that, you know, you can apply only between this and that, this should be happening. There is no constraint as such that you can only apply when this happens. Okay, so you can apply first law of thermodynamics between any two points. Okay, please write down delta Q is equal to delta U plus W. Can be applied between any two points. Okay. But you have to take delta Q between those two points, delta U between those two points, and work done will be between those two points only, whatever you are taking. Fine. But what happens is, when you apply delta Q is equal to delta U plus W for different kinds of processes separately, then not only you can apply this equation, but also you can use the process equation. For example, if you apply this equation between 1 and 2, which is isochoric, apart from first law of thermodynamics, you can use P by T is constant between any two points. Okay. Similarly, when you apply first law of thermodynamics between 2 and 3, you can use volume by temperature is constant. Okay. By the way, temperature should be in Kelvin. Just letting you know, not sure whether. You should be careful. Okay. So you can use between any two points based on what you're dealing and what are you trying to solve. Do not feel any constraint in utilizing the first law of thermodynamics. Okay. And suppose I am using first law of thermodynamics for entire cycle. For full cycle. Suppose it is a cyclic process. I am using delta Q is equal to delta U plus W for the complete cycle or cyclic process, delta U is zero. So basically delta Q will be equal to W only. Okay. Now delta Q is what? Anyone? What is delta Q in a cyclic process? Quick. Skanda, what is delta Q in a cyclic process? Does it matter if it's cyclic or not? What is
the area in area inside the loop in a cyclic process?
Arre, don't use things which I haven't yet discussed. Whatever I have discussed, based on that, tell me what is delta Q. Delta Q is heat absorbed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, in a cyclic process, you have to be careful. Delta Q is net heat absorbed. It is not just heat absorbed. So it is heat absorbed minus heat released. Write it down. At times, we only consider heat that is absorbed. We ignore heat that has rejected. Okay, so make sure this. And in cyclic process, there will always be a portion in the cycle which absorbs the heat, and always there will be a portion in the cyclic process which releases the heat. Heat release can never be zero if there is work done in a cycle. That comes from the second law of thermodynamics that we are going to study later on, not now. Any doubts till now? Anything that you want to discuss or ask? No doubts. Okay, so I'll take numericals. Solve this numerical. Anybody got the answer? You can type in the chat box. Don't speak. You get the answer. By the way, the value of gamma is 5 R/2. Sorry, not 5 R/2. Gamma is 7/5. Okay, the value of gamma is given to you directly.
So gamma is 1.4 only.
Gamma is
4 only for diatomic gas.
What are you saying?
So gamma has a different value for monoatomic and diatomic gases.
Yes, yes, that we are going to learn in kinetic theory of gas. Right now, I'm directly giving you the value of gamma. Now, work done will be positive or negative? First, tell me that. Work done will be positive or negative?
Negative.
Positive.
Okay, which process it is? Adiabatic, isothermal, isochoric, what it is?
Adiabatic.
It is adiabatic because the boundary of the system do not conduct any heat with the surrounding, to the surrounding. So that is the reason why it is the gas inside this undergoes the adiabatic process. And I know that work done is equal to NR delta T divided by 1 minus gamma. We have derived it, right? So I'm directly writing it down. So number of moles is 2. 2 into 8.314 delta T is 400 minus 300, which is 100. Divided by 1 minus 7/5. So when you substitute everything, you'll get negative of 4157 joules. Anybody got this answer? Yeah, 500 R, correct. 500 R. That is correct. Negative of the 500 R. See, gamma is always greater than 1, so denominator will be negative. Okay, so what happens in the adiabatic process adiabatic process internal energy goes down to do the work, because from outside there is no heat supplied. So when internal energy goes down, temperature also goes down, because internal energy is directly proportional to the temperature. So that is the reason why when adiabatic process is there, delta T is negative, work done is positive. Okay, you can think like that. Or if you want to mathematically see it, delta Q is equal to delta U plus W. See, whenever you see a numerical on the thermodynamics, you must write the first law of thermodynamic expression. It will drastically reduce the silly errors. Delta Q is zero. So W should be equal to negative of delta U. So delta U proportional to delta T. So W is negative of the delta T proportional T.